Hi everybody, this video we are going to learn about Bragg's equation. Bragg's equation is very small equation in your textbook. The question is coming for 2 marks like this, but here we are explaining in a little bit, we are explaining in a very brief manner. Just see this. What is Bragg's equation? Bragg's equation, what you are going to study here is Bragg's equation. Why this, what is the purpose of using this equation? This equation is this one, n lambda is equal to 2d sin theta, otherwise 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. In our textbook, state board textbook, directly n lambda is equal to 2d sin theta, that is what Bragg's equation. For what purpose they are using? They are using to calculate the unit cell dimensions. Unit cell dimension means the lengths. Here we are talking about cubic unit cell, so here edge length is a. So any other unit cell, so any other crystal systems are there. We have a 7 crystal systems, no? So that any crystal systems that dimensions you want to find, means we are going to use this equation in the process of x-ray diffraction. X-ray diffraction is one of the method. By using the rays, x-rays, we are going to find the structure of that particular unit cell, structure of the particular atom. In that one, everything you can find out, the dimensions also you can find out. The dimensions means here mainly lengths. Here that length only you are going to say here interplanar distance. What is the purpose of using this Bragg's equation? To find out the interplanar distance between the two successive planes of an atom. See here, atom is there, no? In this one, one atom is there. In that atom, we are going to find out that atom planes are there, means we are going to find the distance between the planes. For that only Bragg's equation we are going to study. Here something, what is the Bragg's equation is telling? N lambda is equal to 2d sin theta. See here, I am going to explain this equation in a theoretical way. What is this n? N is a one number, integer. What is this lambda? We know that is a wavelength. Everybody know that is a wavelength. Here d is the interplanar distance. We are going to study now interplanar distance. Here theta, this theta is the angle of incidence. That wave is falling on the atom. This is what angle, with what angle it is falling under, it is what angle it is undergoing diffraction. That angle, that is theta. That only we are going to study with the diagram. See here, what is that? Structure determination by X-ray diffraction by using Bragg's equation. Structure determination means here, see, what is the Bragg's equation you studied? N lambda, that is equal to 2d sin theta. That only it is saying. See, when a beam of X-ray fall on a crystal plane composed of regularly arranged atom or ions, the X-rays are diffracted. This is the ray. Whatever you are seeing here, this is the ray. We are showing in a straight line way, but the wave will be like this. Generally, we have an idea about the wave. Wave will be like it is falling like this, and it will go like this. We know that wave means this is same. It is falling like this, and it will go like this. We know that. If the waves are in phase after reflection, in phase. What is this in phase? You may have studied in physics this one. In phase means the two waves to maintain the same angle. In phase means waves angle will be, what is the incident, that angle or that theta will be same for the two waves. Otherwise, you are taking any waves means when they can say that two are in phase, here this point and this point will be similar. That time you can say that is a in phase. Generally, in phase means that the angle of incidence, the angle of the wave traveling, no, that will be same. Then you can say in phase. That difference in the distance traveled by the two rays, that is path difference. See, difference means this first wave, number one wave and number two wave, it is traveling, it is falling on this plane. It is a plane, two plane here, first plane and second plane. Two planes are there. We are going to find out this planar distance. This d is there, no? This one. This one we are going to find out, this d. So first plane, that x-ray is falling like this and it is going to diffract like this, and second wave, it is falling like this and it is going to diffract in this manner. That theta, this is the incident angle theta, the same thing will be here also. Then only we can say that is a in phase. What is the path difference? See, up to here these two are same, up to here, here and here same, same distance. The second wave can travel, what is the extra distance? This is the distance. And here also, what is the extra distance? This is the distance. How can you get the distance? Whenever two planes are there, you are draw a line perpendicular to this second wave, perpendicular. That means it will be 90. There is a line here you are drawing, that will be 90. Okay, what I am saying, understanding? So when you have to draw these lines, see these lines here, wherever incident position is there, exactly one perpendicular line you have to draw to the other wave. In a similar way, the same point, other angle you are going to write, which will be 90. Here that angle will be 90, angle will be 90. Automatically, what is the distance? What is the distance difference? When you are comparing two waves, this is the extra distance. This part is the extra distance. Here, this extra distance only you are going to find out. Here, see, what is there? This one you have to find out. This extra distance, this one you have to find out now, and this one you have to find out. This is the one triangle. This is the other triangle. In this triangle, theta value is there, theta. What we know generally, sin theta will apply. What is the formula for sin theta? Sin theta means, what is that? What is that? Opposite side by, what we know? Opposite side by adjacent side. For this sine theta, what is opposite side? For this sine theta, what is opposite side? Wy by, what is adjacent side? Xy. If I need Wy, this is extra distance, no? This wave, what is that? This wave traveled, no? This much extra distance. That distance only, this Wy, I need Wy. Wy is equal to xy sin theta. Okay, in a similar way, this triangle you come. Again, sin theta I am going to use for this one, this angle, theta. Again, what is the formula? Opposite side by adjacent side. What is opposite side? Zy by, what is adjacent side? XY. Here also, what do you need? This part only you need, a YZ part you read. ZY is equal to XY sin theta. This is the extra path. This is the path difference. When you are talking about this wave and talking about this wave, this is the extra distance traveled by the second wave. Otherwise, this is the path difference between the two waves. What is that? This XY. XY, what is that? Not XY, that is, what is that? WY plus YZ. This means what? XY sin theta, XY sin theta. You have to add XY sin theta plus XY sin theta. How much coming? XY sin theta, XY. XY, what we consider here? D. That 2XY sin theta, that is equal to 2d sin theta. This is the, what is that, d value. This is the path difference. This is the path difference. 2d sin theta is the path difference. See that, what is this law telling? Whenever this path difference value is equals to the, must be equals to the integral number of wavelength n lambda. Lambda is the wavelength of these waves. As always, this value always equals to the multiples of n of wavelength. So what you can say? 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. That is what our Bragg's equation. That is what our Bragg's equation. Here that thing only we are going to explain in a clear manner. See that a path decision yz wy yz wy yz, this way you are going to find out. This one triangle, this one triangle, using formula xy sin theta, xy sin theta coming, both are adding means 2d sin theta coming, that is equals to n lambda. This is what Bragg's equation. In our textbook, what is what they can ask in your examination is, they can ask in this one, n is the diffraction order, n value 2d sin theta equal n lambda. No, in this one they will, we have to write the, we are explain the terms here. N value means n is the diffraction order, lambda value wavelength of x-rays, and d, what is that, this is the distance between atomic planes, this is atomic planes, otherwise you can also say as a interplanar, interplanar distance, you can also say interplanar distance, theta, angle at which the interfere occurs, this is the theta, angle of incidence, otherwise angle at which the incident occurs. This is what about our Bragg's equation. This is what about our Bragg's equation. Okay, this is is what here, what important is, the terms are important here. Okay, now we are going to learn the other concept in the next video. Thank you.